people in thy sight here tonight. The words of our mouth, station of our heart, set devil in thy sight here tonight.
By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down. Yeah, we wept when we remembered Zion. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down. Yeah, we wept when we remembered Zion.
Everyone, I'm best friends with Vinny the King. Willie Wise is best friends with Vinny the King.
Balls deep, in the fifth dimension.
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, it's me, the Gimmick King, man, Bon Jesus, here with episode number 13, How Unlucky with a Psychedelic Sasquatch.
Unlucky, yes, absolutely unreal.
This is
up.
What up?
I'm fired up, dude. Are you ready? Dude?
We are going on at one.
Are you ready to live free or die this Saturday,
dude? I hope.
Are you ready to live free or die?
I'm gonna be living.
We're going to New Hampshire.
I'm gonna be living free, but I hope that I don't die because
living,
bro. We might get hypothermia on this thing. We might break a leg on this thing. We might break a fucking arm. We might lose an eye. Have you ever seen that movie where the guy chews his fucking arm off, bro? Have you ever seen that movie where that guy chews the fucking arm off and he gets stuck on some fucking cliff like we're about to go in New Hampshire, bro? I can't believe it. I'm broken. I'm excited, though. I'm excited. I hope I don't lose an arm. I hope I don't lose a leg.
We're beasts, dude.
What the hell?
We're beasts.
What happened to you?
Oh, my mic cut out? Unreal.
What an intro. You know, we were so fired
did
up.
Did none of that get in there?
What?
Did none of my intro get recorded?
I think your entire intro got recorded up
and
until then.
And then I just turned it off?
I heard you up until just now. Right. But that's how hyped we are for the fucking live free or die.
We're fired up.
That's the name of this episode, Live Free or Die.
Yeah.
We're starting it all full boogie, dude. I'm excited. This is going to be a crazy one. So for those who don't know, we're going up to the state, New Hampshire. We're going back, dude. How many times in our lives can we go back to this state? All the time, because it's great.
I've never been there before.
I've been
there.
This
is my first time there, and I am so freaking excited, man. I am dying to see the White Mountains. The White Mountains are legendary mountains. Legendary.
I've been to New Hampshire two times in my entire life, and the first time it was to go and get the greatest drink known to man, the drink that's tattooed on my arm, the Do
S.A.
That's where we got that shit, bro. That was just straight up in New Hampshire, and then we have to go back, we have to see our honey, you know what I mean? And now we're here. Now we're ready to go and climb fucking mountains, bro. We're ready to go to the top and look for a 360 view, baby.
I know. I cannot wait for that shit.
Oh my God.
I cannot
God.
Wait to see this view.
What a, like, I'm, tell these people, how are you going to be ready for something like this? How are you going to get ready to climb a fucking mountain, bro?
I mean, this is, I've done parts of the Appalachians already, I feel like. I've done some in New Jersey. I've done some.
You've been on the AT.
In New York. I've been on the AT, and I've just seen parts of the Appalachians, and I've been in the Catskills. And I feel like this mountain, I know this mountain is tougher than that shit that I've done. And like.
The one that you were hurling on. The one that you,
I don't know if it's tougher than that because the that one where was you like were, super tough.
You were like seizing on but, this fucking mountain.
Dude, I was. I was like freaking out on this mountain at the top of the mountain. I was like, I would literally like, we had the episode where I talked about the breakdown I had on this mountain. And I feel like this, well, that mountain was only like 4,000 feet, I think, or like, yeah, that's 4,000 feet.
But where did you start?
I started around like 2,000 or something like that.
So you're telling me you only climbed 2,000 feet up and you were having a fucking panic attack up there?
Or like 1,500 up to the fucking 4,000, yeah.
Jesus Christ, dude. Yeah. I'm going to have to go find a grandma to get a Xanax.
And now we are going up to...
Being on top of 6,000
We're going up to
feet.
about 6,000. It's going to be 5,300, I think.
Oh my
5,300 feet, I think, is the actual height. It's the fifth highest mountain in the White Mountains.
That's blowing my mind.
It is the fifth highest, and it is the highest outside the presidential range.
I can tell you that right now we are entering fall. Like, the allergies of Johnny Radke are fucking insane. Are there going to be allergies on the top of the mountain? Or am I
there's
not
no trees up there, man. So there's gonna be, the air is going to be nice and crisp up there. It's going to be...
Now,
people say it's windy.
Crisp?
People say that it's also like between 20 and 35 degrees colder than it is at the top of the mountain than it is when you start.
Ah, oh, fuck me, huh?
So that's kind of crazy to think about because it's the weather right now is supposed to be like 55, 60 degrees. And if that's the case, if it's 55 degrees out and we're talking like 30 degrees less than that, and we're talking like... I believe it's like 20 degrees, man.
Holy
know?
Shit, bro. I'm going to have to fucking...
That's what I'm saying.
I'm going to have to wear three pairs of
boxes. The top
of
this mountain might be fucking... Might be cold as shit.
Oh, my God. This is definitely going to be...
it's going to be windy.
A challenge, bro. This is going to be a challenge. This is going to be an adventure, and nonetheless.
So I have... Bring layers. I told you earlier we have a system we're going to bring the pack with. I mean, I'm going to start off with, I think, a pair of... like the long tights and some shorts over them, like the athletic running tights and
some pro wrestling tights
and you know, a t-shirt. And then I have a couple of long sleeve shirts that get thicker as they go. I have a rain jacket and a sweatshirt and I'm gonna bring some gloves too because I really don't know if it's gonna be that cold. So I'm gonna bring a pair of gloves too.
I'm gonna need to bring a pair of gloves. I don't want to lose one finger. You know what I mean? My hand already hurts from God knows what I did.
I'll keep
to it
in my bag. I'm hoping not to use the gloves, but if it does get that cold, I will have gloves and a hat.
If it comes down to Johnny Radke losing fingers, we're gonna have to. Somebody else is gonna have to host a show. I'm gonna have to be the second mic. CJ, you're gonna have to learn how to do all this shit if Johnny Radke comes back.
Oh my God!
With not one finger, let me tell you. But I don't think we're gonna have to. You're telling me that these people are going and they like the clothes they're wearing. It looks like they are, you know.
Well, I follow hashtag Franconia Ridge on Instagram, and from what I've been seeing lately, a lot of people have not been. I mean, they are dressing warm. They are. They definitely have like some of them have like hoodies on and shit like that. But like they're not like. It's not like super cold weather. Like it doesn't look like they're freezing.
They're not. It's not fucking.
It looks like they're cold. It looks like it's cold up there.
But you're not talking. This ain't no Antarctica, bro.
But it's not like that. No, it's not.
We're not
gonna
have huskies coming to rescue. No Antarctica.
No.
So
and then so that is gonna be some shit, man. I'm really really excited about this. I've been like dying to see this. It's like rated in the top 10 hikes in Nat Geo in the entire world. So that's really cool that like we're gonna get the chance to take a stab at it and. Praying that the weather is
a little stab.
I'm praying that the weather holds off, man.
Oh, for Christ's sake. I hope that we don't get screwed with some shit.
I don't
want to
get clouds, you know? It's like, it would suck if it rains and it's like a storm coming. We like can't do it at all.
We get struck
but
by lightning.
If it's cloudy, we could still do it, but like that would suck, dude. And then like, we got to hope that like the cloud moves out of the way and like I'm sure that we'll get blessed with a sick view in the time that we're up there, you know?
We're just trying to see
there's going to be a point in time where there's going to be a point in time where we get blessed with a view no matter what, I feel like, you know? And it's all about the experience and the journey the entire way rather than the destination of it.
The journey, dude. 8 miles of up, down.
Yeah, it's going to be a journey for sure, you know? You're going to have to dig deep for this, and I'm excited for that, you know?
I feel like we should take a peek on this journey with us. Peek is my cat.
You think Peek would love this?
My cat is absolutely obese, up in a harness. Dude, and she would need, if she did this, I think she would come back skinny, you know what I mean? Like, she looks like she's borderline diabetic, so I don't know, maybe, Peek, you want to go climb a mountain, bro?
I think she would run away, man.
She would love that shit. She would be like a mountain dog, dude, but a mountain peak.
I know, I've seen some really cool mountain dogs on these trails. It makes me want to get a dog so bad.
And these kids that wear sandals when they hike. So these kids are climbing the shit wearing sandals, bro. Johnny Radke's got this shit. Yeah. And then that video, that guy who's what is his gimmick, bro? He's fat guy that climbs.
The fat guy in the woods.
Fat guy in the woods did this shit. Wait, did he go to the top like the shit we're doing? Did he go all the way?
He made it all the way to the top.
So fat guy in the woods made it all the way up, and I can't. I know I'm a former smoker. You know what I mean? So, is that what it takes to take me out? No way! A fat guy in the woods did it. I'm gonna fucking do this shit.
That's what I think. Dude.
And I don't think he didn't look like he. I mean, he looked like he was struggling. Dude. You know, sometimes there's videos of him. He's like dry heaving on a rock.
that's what I look like in the Catskills, though.
So, like, I think that, you know, I know who I am. You know what I mean? I know what I'm capable of.
I think we could do this shit, man. I know we could do this shit.
There was not really.
I don't even think it's like, I know we can do it. It's just a matter of letting go of yourself and being in the moment. And I think that's what I love about hiking so much is, like, it forces you to be in the moment. It forces you to get to that flow state. And there's going to be no doubt in my mind that come Saturday,
we're going to be flowing.
We have no choice. Because it's going to be that, or it's going to be break an ankle or get fucked. You can't turn around. Like, you know what I mean? Like, the way the trail is, it's so intense and rugged, and there's rocks everywhere. And, like, you have to really pay attention to every step that you put your foot down on, you know? And,
Jesus
like,
Christ.
You got to be in the moment, in the zone. And you become one with nature and life and, like, just a mountain.
Are we going to be expecting?
It's a very rewarding feeling.
We're going to be expecting any friends along this trail, like some animal friends. Will they join us on this trail? Will we see any? Are there animals on a mountain? Who knows?
Yeah, I mean, imagine we see mountain goats, dude. That'd be crazy, huh?
They'd probably fuck me up. They would be like, look at this little bitch, bro.
I don't think we're going to see any animals. Maybe some snakes earlier on when we get by the waterfalls and shit like that. Maybe some, like, deer, raccoons. But I don't think there's any, like, serious animals up there because it's too fucking crazy, like, for them to live up there.
The craziest thing would
be... There's nothing living up there. There's not even trees up there, bro. There's, like, no life up there.
So how does a mountain goat eat? The people that come and hike, they fucking feed them?
What's that?
The mountain goats survive?
They suckle out of the rocks. They have, like, minerals in the rocks. And they like, suckle the water and the rocks and the minerals out of the rocks.
What the fuck?
Yeah, it's crazy. They literally eat out of the rocks. I saw it the other day. And that's why they're able to, like, fucking do that shit on the side of the mountain. And that's why they choose to do that. Because they need the nutrients from that mountain.
They need the rock to suck on.
It's kind of crazy. It's, like, in their brain to do that, you know? It's a weird thing.
They're born to suck. Basically,
they're born to suck on that rock. Suck all that shit.
Imagine, like, that's all you eat is just like they give you a rock and it's like, here, suck on the same rock, like, all the time. It tastes the same every day of your life. I'd be so pissed, you know what I mean? There's nothing different. It's
that's
like,
why they're always traveling different mountains and climbing this shit.
Do you
they
think a different?
Taste a different rock.
When I get up on top of this mountain, I'm gonna suck.
And you're gonna mountain goat it up there?
I'm gonna suck on a rock and
suck out of that.
And see if,
and
see, you know, I'm gonna see what does this taste like? You know, can this be? Maybe it is so good.
Shot, dude.
Maybe it's so good that I never leave. The mountain, like the mountain goes.
I don't think it's gonna be that good.
And I start to, I get addicted to sucking on the rock. You know what I mean? That's how they get stuck up there. You see, like these naked people running around. It's like, what are they doing? Oh, they're rock suckers.
Nah, we'll see, man. I think you're gonna like it, dude. I think you're gonna enjoy the enjoy hiking up.
I think I'm definitely in a better shape than I was when we did the Greenbelt Trail because that shit took me out for a couple days.
I really enjoyed that.
I didn't fucking dry heave on the Greenbelt Trail, you know. But I'm in much better shape right now. I'm like actually working out like every day.
I feel
day.
Like it's something that's gonna be worth it, you know? Because when you get up there, it's like I don't know. Like the thing is like How many people in America? Like, it's such a beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful sights in America. And how many people can fucking see that shit?
What is this list?
And the only way, and the only way to see this shit is to fucking do this shit.
There's no Fugazi.
So that's like the cool. That's like that. That to me is like so cool that like, it's one of the coolest sites in America, and the only way to see it is to get up there, but with your fucking feet. So like, how many people?
1 foot in front of the other.
I don't know. It's just cool to like to fucking experience it, you know. And it's cool to see it, and cool to be one of the people that have been willing to fucking go up there and look at it.
There's a list of people that have done this, such as MBJ, the psychedelic Sasquatch, and Fat Guy in the Woods. You know,
Fat Guy in the Woods. Did it,
we hope that we can inspire you to fucking do this shit. You know, you already know. I'm hoping that it doesn't fucking, because like when we were getting towards the end of the GBT, brother, I was like, fuck this vlog, fuck the people, and fuck these masks, you know what I mean? So, but this is an adventure. This is a USA moment. We're cracking a USA on the top of the shit. Therefore, this thing needs to be filmed. So I'm trying to think, yeah. Like, is it like, how fucking shot is Johnny Radke going to get? Is he going to be able to film this shit, or is he going to be like, fuck this shit, now we just got to fucking drive through? Maybe I'll just fucking just hit record and fucking on the fucking camera. What the fuck is wrong with this guy? He's climbing this fucking mountain. That's what he's doing. He's fucking driving.
No, I think that, I don't know, man. We're going to find out, I guess, you know. But we'll take our time because I want to fucking experience it and soak it in. So
my biggest fear is getting fucked on this shit when the sun is coming down, dude. That if you people don't know, go back, listen to episode 8. I think it was episode 8, bro. I had a panic attack when the fucking sun went down. And we were in the woods, and it was dark, and I was seeing shit like the same shit. We were going in like circles. I was like, oh my god. I was like, I've just seen this shit like 3 times.
I was like, oh, maybe we could stay up there for fucking sunset and then come down. And I was like, no, I don't think Tracky would like that.
Not very much, dude. That shit would be fucking, oh my god. Then you get fucked in the rocks, and that's, oh, I don't know, dude. That's
going fucking, down is gonna suck.
That's what I'm saying.
Going
know?
Down is gonna suck.
Going up's gonna be rough. But one of the cool things
is that I think like halfway down the mountain, when you're coming down after getting off Lafayette, is this like little AMC hut thing, and it's like this like Appalachian Trail hut center thing. It's like open 24/7, and it's like a
center.
It's like an emergency, like, cause sometimes it's like fucking shitty like conditions, and like it's like it comes quick, you know. And if it comes quick, it's like you might get seriously fucked up, so people will run to this shit and like get in there for cover. And like, obviously I hope that that's not the case for us,
it's
but
like fucking Pokemon,
it'd be cool
center.
To just pop in there, and they sell the beverages, and I think and
Mountain
they
Dew,
sell snacks, and I think it's like warm in there and stuff, you know. So it'd be cool to go in there and check that out on the way down the mountain, and separate a little bit of the struggle, the mental struggle and the physical struggle of going down, and the mental struggle of, like, you know, it sucks when you already seen what you want to see and you already accomplished what you want to accomplish.
Now you're done,
and you're only halfway done because you have to go down. That's like a brutal, brutal feeling. But we're more than halfway done at that point because it's 3 mountains, so. At that point, we're like way more than fucking halfway done. We're like, it's only 3 miles down, I think, or only 2 miles down. So, and I think it's like, it goes by quick. They said the average time it takes to go down the mountain is like an hour. And the average time it takes to go up the mountain is like 3.5. So, we'll see. You know, the average time to do the entire hike is 8 hours. I say if we give ourselves 10 hours to enjoy it, you know, 12 hours for emergency, we should be okay.
So you are the professional hiker. I'm just here for the ride. You know what I mean? At least I'm just joining.
I think I could definitely do the whole thing in 8 hours, but I want to enjoy it. So I'm saying 10 hours.
We want to see some sights once we get to the top. You
so
know
the
what
thing
I mean?
Is, like, I think, you know, we'll get there early because we're leaving it. We're going to leave around 9:30, 10 o'clock at night on Friday. And my goal was to sleep after work. I get off work at like 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. So I want to get home from work, fucking pass out, literally. Have my bags packed, everything ready to go, sleep. And then I want to, like, wake up. Like, I set my alarm, wake up at, like, 9 o'clock, 9:30, get my shit. Let's go.
Let's go, he says.
Be out, drive through the night.
Now here's my like thing. It's like, what is Johnny Rack? Is Johnny Racky gonna stay awake during this ride? Because we got Johnny Racky, B-Pat, and CJ driving. When you are in the car with my good friend CJ, and it is late at night, or he's just tired, you know, it's been a long day. This guy is the scariest to be sitting next to, because your eyes, I'll be looking at, I'll check on you sometimes, and I'll look over, and your fucking eyes are closed, and I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna fucking die.
So why don't you drive at some point then?
I will fucking drive for...
If you see me getting like that, dude.
I will fucking... If you feel like that, you can tell me. If you're fucking exhausted, be like fucking... Hey, you can drive, my guy. I'll fucking drive, you know what I mean? All
right, cool.
There's only one time in my life cool. I was ever behind... I mean, actually, I have... If I fallen asleep, you know, fucking when you
crashed
sitting,
one time falling asleep.
I was
dude.
Sitting in traffic. Oh, I hit the fucking. I was sitting in traffic going to NYWC after a long day of like work and school and being up since like 4 a.m. And it was, I was just driving. It was stuck in traffic. Stop, go, stop, go. And at some point, I fucking fell asleep and stop, go, stop, go. And I was hitting the side of the fucking
shit.
The thing. And I was like, whoa, we are awake now, for fuck's sake. Holy shit. And fucking, so that was like the one time I fell asleep. And then when we were coming home from Wilkes-Barre, I was driving. It was all these crazy like turns and shit. But I was just so tired from the adventure of fucking... You know, the day before, getting maybe like an hour or two of sleep and leaving at 3 a.m. And now it's fucking 1 a.m. the next day. And I was just like driving, not my car, my buddy at the time's car. And I was just, I was in and out of it. I was like dreaming kind of while driving. I was like, holy fuck.
Holy shit.
But I got to this guy's house somehow, some way. I was like, we did it. Yo.
Scary.
Yeah, so I don't want one of those moments on our trip up there. I don't
no, that's what I'm saying. But I think if I take a nap after... If I take a nap after work and I bring an energy drink, I think I'll be good. I think I'll be good for the first like 2 or 3 hours. Then I'll take an energy drink and I'll be good for the next 2 or 3 hours. You know? And I think we'll be good morning. Good morning.
Good morning, Baltimore. We are ready to go.
But, what was I going to say? What was I going to say, though, is that, yeah, I would like to ideally... If we leave, it's like it's supposed to be 6 hours, but I feel like if there's no one on the road, let's cut that down to like five and a half hours, you know, the way I drive if it's late night. So we get there like 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, like 3 o'clock in the morning, 2:30. Let's say 3 time. In the morning.
It
you
gives
know?
Us a little nap.
Take a little nap, you know? You get there at 3 in the morning, you take another little nap. And then when you wake up, 6:30, 7 a.m. Let's say 6:30. We should get out there. I got headlamps too, so if you want to start a little bit in the dark, I don't mind fucking.
I don't mind
getting
starting,
after it a little bit early.
I don't mind starting at like fucking the crack of fucking dawn. You know what I mean? Like as soon as we see that shit is starting to come up, we're fucking ready to go. You know?
Yep.
I would not mind starting then just to fucking, you know, just to do it. Because if we have extra time at the end of the day, we got extra time at the end of the day. We're not stuck up there. We're not dying.
Yeah, we I'd rather live. Have extra time at the end of the day to hang out and do some other stuff.
We will fucking live. We will watch the Islander game.
As you know,
bar.
My girlfriend's name is Brittany, and my name is CJ. And we found a sports bar nearby that is called Brittany and CJ Sports Bar. So it'd be cool to go there for some wings.
That's where we're showing up. We gotta support the Islanders.
CJ's fucking sports bar. The Islanders are playing game 7 at that point. We definitely have to watch some of that.
This is getting down
get
to the nitty gritty.
Get Kendall Stickman over there. Kendall Stickman, how far are you from New Hampshire?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
We're right near Boston, for Christ's sake.
Come hither. If I can, we'll come. He'll take candlestick shots for us once again, dude. I'm ready. You know, the merch game has been on fire as of late, bro.
You get some sick shit?
We got some sick. Right now, I'm wearing a cotton candy, as you would say, Man Bun Mania t-shirt. It is a little hot pink with the baby blue Man Bun Mania writing.
Is that
on
new?
That shit. This is brand new.
Really?
Dude. And you can walk out of here with what size are you? An XL, brother?
2X? You got 2X?
I got XL, but they run big, bro. It's pretty baggy on a fucking bun.
I'll probably
this is
rock
a medium.
The XL.
So, these shirts, fire, bro. You can get them by DMing at Man Bun Jesus. But they are, I love the Man Bun Mania gimmick, bro. This is the third color. Now, this is John Cena shit. This is Fruity Pebbles, The Rock would say. You know what I mean? He's selling out. Now, I'm selling in. MBJ's got the merch, and this is some nice shit. And I'm thinking that when the reorder of Wrestle Buddies come, I want to change up the Groovy Grizzly one. I want that shit looking more like the Groovy Grizzly. And I'm definitely going to be ordering fucking Kendo Stick Man Wrestle Buddies. For the good people that's of the insane. Fifth Dimension. I told him, I said, you need to sign over your likeness to me because that's going to go in. I want to be like, you need to make this guy because this guy, this is a character you need, bro. Shit. This is going to be merch. But yeah, when the fuck, and this is the big question, bro, these stupid wrestling shows.
When are the shows coming back? When are the fans coming back to buy the merch?
That's what I'm saying. You know what I mean? You can sell merch here and there on the internet, but you're not doing your shit. And when the people see you do your... When they see MBJ do a backflip over the top rope...
They say, holy shit, I need a goddamn t-shirt.
They say, I need a t-shirt, my kid. Yeah, he needs a wrestle buddy. He wants to hold the
little MBJ.
My kid
said he wants a Groovy Grizzly keychain. You guys have those?
He says he wants stickers everywhere. On his bedroom wall, on the potty. He wants them everywhere
he goes.
On
his skateboard.
On his goddamn skateboard bro, you want to tell me some fucking weird ass shit? The last time we did this show, the Squatch and the Bun episode 12.
Yes, let's this is some crazy weird fucking shit.
The government and like STF, even he sent me like the link to this movie that I think is on Netflix about like kind of the same shit. And he said this shit freaked him out and it's gonna freak me out. And like I was like, oh,
what movie is it?
It's called Social Dilemma. So
is it a real thing?
I haven't watched it yet, but it's a movie it's like a documentary thing or whatever.
Wow.
On like Netflix, I think. I'm pretty sure. Social Dilemma. But he said this is about this shit. So we come in, and Johnny Radke, he's got the Flake received a longboard for her 21st birthday. A week after getting that longboard, MBJ and the Flake said, hey, well, let's go learn how to ride this thing. That would be sick. And the Flake, you know, she fell off and she tore ligaments, I guess. But she acted like it was fucking bloody murder. She acted like it fucking, she snapped her ankle in two, that the bone was sticking out and everything. But after that, she decided she's never going to ride this longboard again. It is now Johnny Radke's. Johnny Radke has stickers. He has merch. His own merch. He fucking decks out this skateboard with Johnny Radke stickers, Groovy Grizzly stickers, the whole nine yards. And CJ comes in, and he looks at it, and he goes, oh, it looks sick.
What did I say? I said something like, ah, oh, there it is.
Well, yeah, that's what it was. Like, that's what it was. Ah, there it is.
I said something like, ah, oh, there it is. Because you were talking about it at one point, and I knew, like, you know, I don't know. I think that's what I said.
And then I responded with, it's something
about the stickers.
But we never mentioned
the word longboard. I never mentioned the word skateboard. I never mentioned any of that. I don't even know what brand it is. It has like a fucking two triangle thing. Oh, Illuminati. It's got some fucking three triangle shit because there's another one inside of it. Whoa.
That's how they knew, dude. But
no, I don't know what kind of brand this is, though.
The Illuminati skateboard. This is.
But so I go home and like the next day I'm at work and I'm on Facebook and I get a freaking Facebook ad for the same exact, like to a T, like the same exact longboard.
I think the only thing different was like the colors of the fucking wheels. And I shit you not, you probably buy that shit and you're going to get fucking black wheels on it. They're not going to send the stupid red wheel or whatever it was on that shit. But the same brand, same gimmick.
How weird is that?
We didn't even mention that it was a longboard while talking about the sticker.
I was almost like, yo, does this shit have a camera that's like fucking scanning shit around me? Or is there a chip in that that's connected to the like your phone? If you I had the Amazon app on my shit.
Well, you know, it's weird.
So you probably got that on Amazon. You think, like, do you think the Amazon maybe like tags their shit and it's like, oh, but it'll trigger it?
I can tell you this. I think that the TV has a fucking camera. I know that the Mac that we are recording on right now that is set up has a camera that's facing that longboard. This computer is connected to my phone. Me and you are connected through the phone. Is that what it was? Like, and if so, why the fuck is that a thing? You know what I mean? That is so weird that a camera in my house gave you an ad of something that I have that we talked about that we didn't even use the words of. What the fuck?
It's bugged out, bro. It makes you think, like, who's behind
who's
the camera?
Who's watching me? I know they're watching me. It's just,
who's behind the camera? Who is the man behind the camera?
You ever see that fucking South Park, bro?
No.
That guy is fucking... He's watching everybody. Like they're they're banned from going to the bathroom. That's what it is. So the government is watching them. Like they have to put on a seatbelt when they take a shit. So they're sitting down and take a shit, and he's making sure everybody's got a seatbelt on. And he's going by, and this is just some fucking. It's like the Mark, you know what I mean? He looks like the Mark. And he's fucking this fucking fat, hairy motherfucker, and he's jerking off watching these people.
Oh my God, dude. That's in the South Park episode?
Yeah, dude. But then fucking, what do you call it? Cartman finds him. He fucking, he's looking at him. And when he's going by, he's beating his meat. He's going, and he fucking passes it, and he sees him, and he passes it again. He slows down. And he goes back, and he sees this motherfucker, and he's like, what is this little motherfucker doing? And then you send the
cops there, bro. I'm going to tell my kid to get him to stop watching porn. I'm going to say, every time you jerk off, there's someone else jerking off behind the camera.
Looking at you.
That'll freak him out.
But like, who is watching?
But honestly, that might be true, though. Like, who the fuck is behind the camera?
We're being watched 100%.
I'm not even
fucking kidding
when I say that
shit. It's so weird.
I'm going to tell my kid that for real, though. I'm be like, yeah, you can fucking, it's out there, you know, but just know that every time you fucking jerk off, there's someone else behind the camera jerking off to you.
Oh my God, imagine this. Some fucking freak. He's just fucking sitting there watching you. Returning. Like, oh, gross, dude. Oh, Jesus.
I can't wait for this new South Park episode coming out.
Oh, the pandemic, bro.
The pandemic. It's a pandemic called the paramedics. Shout out Sick Vic.
I was blasting that shit today, honestly. I was driving around. It's on my SoundCloud fucking liked.
It's a pandemic.
When I go on my SoundCloud liked, I think it's actually public. Fucking the Squatch and the Buns fucking account on SoundCloud. If you look at the liked videos, it goes from fucking.
You can see the shit that we like.
Yeah, it goes from.
Schizo like, Flows, bro. Fucking Sick Vic, dude.
It goes to fucking Wet Ass
Schizo
Pussy.
Schizo Flows on Instagram.
By Cardi B. Fucking Wet Ass Pussy Aka.
You have that shit liked? Wet Ass Pussy?
Oh, dude, that song is a fire bop, honestly.
It goes to fucking Sick Vic, bro.
Fucking pandemic. Someone called the paramedics.
That's what I'm talking about.
Dead ass, dead.
That's Undo-P, shit.
Absolutely. Tell me about Billy, dude.
Our good boy. I did end up getting to go see him. I know last week.
We were on a low last week. You know what I mean? It's been a shitty week.
Overall, it has been a shitty week.
We're the fam over here. You know what I mean? The fam at the Squatch and the Bun here. It's been a fucking rough one, but at least you got to be blessed with that good, you know, fucking music. Really,
I can't even explain to you how crazy this shit was.
Here we go. You tell.
First of all, like, I was so happy, like, at the end of the night, I think, like, when I get back to the hotel room, I literally spend like 20 minutes just like hysterically laughing uncontrollably, and I cannot like explain like why I was laughing, and my girlfriend was just like, she was laughing at me laughing, and like I was just like, I felt like a little kid. I don't know, like, it just felt so good to hear live music, you know, to hear like live music again. I felt like, it felt like we finally had like recess after being in like timeout for like 7 months, you know?
Oh, so long of time.
It was crazy. Seeing all the being back with the hippie community. Like, let me tell you something. Like, Billy Strings is something else, man. Cause like, he plays like, he's incredible at this music. And he plays bluegrass. For those that haven't heard of him, he's like I think he's the greatest like bluegrass musician. But, like, he's not only a bluesgrass musician, he's just a great guitar player and a great musician in general. And, like, he plays this classical music, and he has this mandolin player up there with him. He has a bass player that plays the old school bass, and he has a banjo player up there. And that's it. There's no drummers. There's no freaking piano player. There's no keyboardist. And he gets a crazy amount of sound out of these four guys with strings. And like, holy shit, man, you know, and like the fact that he's playing this classical music, he brings out these fans that are like classical music fans. So you have 70-year-old couples that are like huge bluegrass fan musicians, like huge bluegrass fans.
Huge.
All the bluegrass fans are there because Billy Strings is the best bluegrass musician alive. And then all the hippies are there because Billy Strings is like one of the greatest fucking psychedelic musicians alive. So it's like, holy shit, and he's fucking 26 years old, you know?
He's a young man.
So he's like, he's playing this shit in a parking lot, and he's bringing these people together from all ages and all walks of life, you know? Like fucking classy cowboy folk and like dirty woke hippie folk, you know?
Them.
And like 5-year-olds to fucking 85-year-olds. And they're all just there being respectful, being socially distant, staying in their space that we were given to party. We got a parking spot and a parking spot next to us. And, you know, the concert was supposed to start at 7:30. he came out and started playing it, that shit at 7:30 on the fucking dot. He was like, as soon as the fucking shit was 7:30, he was fucking out there ready to go, you know? And like, he was just as excited to play this music as we were to fucking hear music. It's like, we both were waiting 7 months for this shit, dude. Like, you know, Friday night was probably a sick show. I listened to it, actually. It was a good show. But Saturday was sold out. And he knew that shit was sold out. For fucking, that shit's been sold out, you know? So he fucking knew. And like, he came out and he just started shredding right off the jump. And like, I don't know. He just put on like such a fucking incredible show. It was so like... just amazing to see everybody fucking going so nuts to this shit and feeling it the same way that I was feeling it, you know? And like, there was a point where I went to the bed. I was like, I don't know, like, I was drinking a lot. I was partying a lot. I was freaking hanging out there in the loft for a while before the show started. And I was like, am I just fucked up right now? Or is like, is this shit like next level, like incredible good, you know? And then I go to the bathroom and I'm like, I'm realizing that like everyone else around me is like in the same exact boat that I'm in, feeling the same way. And they're just like,
mind blown.
And they're just like, it, like people is like jaws are on the floor, you know, like watching this fucking guy play the guitar. And like, I don't know if Billy Strings is anywhere within any fucking remote area to you, I highly recommend just fucking going to see him and just experiencing this shit live. Cause like it's a music that's meant to be indulged live. And that's the way you should fucking experience it. It's like the fucking Grateful Dead, you know? And like, the fact that he's 26 years old is something else, man. I can't wait to fucking see what the future brings for him. I'm a huge fan. I will see him every single time I can from now on. And like, that is a guarantee. I'm a huge Billy Strings fan.
A huge Unreal. Billy Strings.
But like, so I was going to play this little part of the concert on here if I can, you know? I'll see what I can do with my phone and shit. But like, I thought that this was like some really incredible shit. Like, you know, like he is like obviously like a psychedelic artist and whatever. And he like, you know, a lot of people talk about like dying and like the Grateful Dead. And it's like, it's a metaphor for like taking a chance and like becoming like losing your ego and just like being your true self and like just letting everything go, you know, and just being in the moment. And like, you have to kill your ego to be alive, you know? And like, so he does this song. It's like a 20-minute crazy song and walks off the stage. And we're like, holy shit, you know? Oh my God, amazing. Like, yes. Like, wow. Everyone's honking their horns and shit.
Fucking honking.
And fucking, yeah. So all of a sudden, he comes back on stage with this guitar, like, on his back. And he's the only one on stage. And it's just a fucking beam of light. Like, they have the fucking crazy light set up and shit. So this is a beam of light shining down on him, whatever. And he performed this fucking a cappella song. And like, I thought it was just like so like brave and like for him to go out there and just like take a chance, like singing this song. Like, I don't know, like, you know, like he's not known as a singer, you know, he's a guitar player. I mean, he's got a great voice and shit, but like, and this song was so crazy and like psychedelic. The song was literally about what he was doing, you know, it was about a guy taking a chance into the unknown and like, letting their freaking like spirit just like fly out there. And I was just like, I don't know, I had like goosebumps watching this shit. And like, the wind picked up as he was fucking doing this shit. And like, it was just like something else, you know? And like, I looked at like Brittany and she was just like, even she was like jaw on the, like, oh, are you hearing this shit? You know? Like, it was like some crazy shit, you know? And then he fucking, of course, like, the band came back on stage and he ended the concert on one more song, like a fun one, you know? But this one song was just like some intense shit. So I'm going to play a little bit of it. I don't need to play the whole thing. You'll get the idea. But like, you know, picture like him coming back out on stage by himself, you know? Like fucking guitar on his back.
And am I born to die? To lay this body down? And must my trembling spirit fly? Soon as
That song gave me goosebumps when I heard that shit live, and like the fact that like every single person was like losing their minds 2 minutes before that, and when he came out on stage, it just got dead quiet, and people were like, people just stopped whatever they were doing, you know. People were like starting their cars up, some of them, and they just got out of their car. Like everyone just like stopped what they were doing, and like it was like the world stopped for those like 3 minutes, you know, and like I thought it was gonna be a quick thing, and then it just kept going and going, and I was like, oh my. Like, oh my God, like how, like, you know, like, I just thought it was like very brave of him to like get up there and like to do that song and like, you know, by himself like that and like take the chance and like, it just really blew me away, you know. I was like, holy shit, you know.
This man
like,
took a chance.
You know, man. And then like, and then he ended the concert on a good note. He brought everybody out and they played this like fun song and he's like, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Love you, you know. But he's like, I was like, oh, what a concert, you know. But like, holy shit, you know, like, it just made me want to like, when we left, I was like, even Brittany was like, we got to get a concert ticket for tomorrow. I'm like, yeah, because like, it wasn't sold out, you know. And then the next day he covered some freaking Dead songs and some Fish songs. It was on a Sunday, you know, they have that saying like never miss a Sunday show because it's supposed to be like Sunday church and shit.
So miss like, church, folks. You know,
that's pretty cool. Like he took him to church on Sunday, played some Dead songs, some fucking Fish songs.
Hell yeah. But that's what's up, bro. I'm glad that you had one hell of an
it was a good experience, man, you know. And it just made me miss music. It made me miss being inside for concerts, and like it was really cool being like at a concert, but I do miss being like inside for a concert, like in a theater or something, you know. I can't imagine like seeing somebody like that with the energy like bouncing around off the walls and shit, you know.
And,
like, people inside, you know. And I miss like all that shit, you know. Like the Dead has to come back soon.
Oh my God. I need a fucking Dead and Co. show.
I know what that is.
I need one of those in my fucking bones, bro. In my soul. I need to hear that good music. I listen to it all the time. I'd like to hear it live. You know what I mean? That's could 2020 at least give me that, for Christ's sake? You know, it's taking so much away.
I don't
away.
Think it's gonna, man. I mean, it might give you an announcement for a future concert, but
Jesus.
Did you see that thing John Mayer did the other day where he said he would love to freaking be back on stage?
John Mayer said to Mickey Hart, I fucking want to play and look across the stage and look at you. So these rumors that we talked about on a former episode, those rumors are seem to be fugazi, and we are starting new rumors that it's not ending, bro. And it's going to keep on going, and we are going to be able to hear the good music again and again and again.
I hope so.
I want to hear, you had a USA story for me. You were talking about our greatest.
Oh, yes.
Our drink, the
so
drink.
The people for Billy Strings, it was pretty cool. Like, I didn't know them. My girlfriend was friends with them, and they picked us up. And it was cool. Like, we stayed at the hotel right near the concert, so they picked us up on the way there and drove us there and shit. And they were cool people, you know. They were also into jam bands. They're big Disco Biscuit fans. So we were talking about other bands that we would like to see together. And I think we made a friend that we could actually go to some more concerts with in the future. And anytime someone's playing in PA, I would like to see these guys again. You know, they're going to a festival next year, Peach Festival. And a lot of fucking bands are playing. I know J-Rad is playing. Billy Strings is playing. Goose is playing. Humphries McGee is playing. Like, a lot of these bands that I like to fucking listen to are going to be there. So I was like, oh, that'd be cool to go to Peach Festival next year, you know, if that shit actually does happen and is a thing.
If we get music, for Christ's sake.
You know, so they were cool people, but we were talking, I don't know how it came up, but somehow, like, Mountain Dew came up and DUSA came up, and we were talking about the shit, and fucking Your Tattoo came up, and we were talking about all the whole DUSA was explained to them, and they were just like, what the fuck, you know? Like, he couldn't wrap his head around that shit.
The fuck you mean he couldn't wrap his head around
it? It was like... He was like, so wait, they fucking drove that far to get it? And I'm like, yeah, you know.
There was
like,
no more.
I'm like, that shit is the best. Like, you know, like, what are you going to do at that point? And he's like, so is it really that good? And I'm like, you know, it's good. It's like a really good Mountain Dew, you know.
Yeah,
it's just
good,
like, you got to, you know, you got to experience, you know. It's like, you know, you got to experience it, you know. And like, he's like, all right, you know. And then like a little bit later, he was like, you know, that tattoo sounds fucking stupid as shit.
Oh,
you know?
Fuck,
he's like,
this guy.
He's like, I'm not gonna lie, that sounds really fucking stupid. And I'm like, hey, I don't know, you know, like, it is stupid, but like, it's kind of funny, you know. That's like the point of it, you know, like, fucking, you know, like, I don't know, like, it's fucking DUSA, you know.
Hell yeah, it is.
And he's like, so what does it taste like? And I'm like, well, that's the thing, brother. I'm like, you gotta earn one, dude. You gotta experience one, you know.
Yeah, so
and there's none left. So honestly, fucking, you know, good luck, you know.
That's what I'm saying. These people don't get it. You know what I mean? They don't.
And then, like, after a while, he was like, fuck, like, I want to try one.
Yeah,
I'm
I
like,
bet you do.
I'm like, yeah, you fucking, you do want to try one, you know? And like, fucking, you can't, dude, you know? You have to have a fucking, you have to have a DUSA moment.
Yeah, damn right, motherfucker. you have to have a supply of DUSA and able to bring upon a DUSA
shit.
Moment.
It's just my God, this is my addiction. I didn't even pop it. How fucking shocking.
You're going to drink this shit now at fucking like
now
10
I'm not
o'clock,
drinking it,
whatever,
now.
9 o'clock at
I'm
night?
I'm not drinking it now. Now I'm done.
We got the new Monster.
But this is my new addiction, is the fucking Monster Mules, dude. I know you've been talking about the fucking nicotine and shit. I've been falling into nicotine traps, too.
Dude, I'm chewing gum right now, dude.
I've been fucking smoking shit at work. Like, fucking people will give me fucking little puffs.
Dude,
and
the little puffs.
The puff bars,
hard.
Dude. The puff bars are so strong.
The puff bars at the spot, bro. Those puff bars fuck you up, bro. They fucking make
fuck
you spin.
They do make you spin.
Sometimes I drive past.
It fucking feels so good.
I drive past these spots. I was actually at another spot the other day, and like, I was like, well, you, I fucking, this wasn't the other day. This was like 2 weeks ago. I had a crack. I bought a fucking disposable, and I was in there. I was like, you guys got any puff bars? And of course, you know, fucking motherfucker pulls out some fucking stash of shit, and I was like, oh my God. This motherfucker gave it to me for free, so I didn't feel too bad. And then I was smoking it, and I was like, oh, gross. I fucking smoked like half of it, and I threw it out. I was like, this is good.
Yeah, that's how
at
you
least
got
I didn't,
it.
I didn't feel
that's
fucking.
Good.
I didn't feel bad throwing throwing it out because it was free.
Yeah,
I was
that's
like,
good.
Get rid of this shit. And then fucking I chew the gum. The fucking.
I know. I take hits every once in a while. Like at work, I didn't take any today or anything.
Sometimes I have days. You know, days of fucking frustration. And the Nick helps with that.
I'm trying to not do it at all. I don't really do it at all, except for at work. That's the thing, though. You know, it's a slippery slope. It's a slippery slope.
That's where it started with
but
me.
But now I'm addicted full boogie to the fucking energy drinks because I get tired. And when I get tired, these things fucking help me out, dude.
I drink an energy drink like every day. It's fucking like crack
and
caffeine.
I feel like if I didn't fucking drink it, I would like be losing weight a lot quicker. And like, it's annoying. And I'm addicted to it. Like, why am I addicted to,
you know, I was drinking a lot of these ones, you know, the good old Monsters. I love my Monster, but I stopped myself kind of, and I switched over to Bang, bro.
I love Bang, dude. I drink Bang all the time.
I don't like them like the Monsters, you know, but I drink them because I go to the gym like every day, and apparently it's got
creatine
and amino acids and fucking, it's a fucking.
Yep, I've been drinking them.
It's a wake up drink too.
But now they have this shit. I love Moscow Mules. And now they have Monster Mules.
I have had the Monster. I don't know.
In the back of it, the shit says like some dude. I say shit, bro. It's fucking limited shit, dude. And once it's gone, it's gone. It literally says fucking available for a limited time only in a collectible copper style can. Grab one soon because when they're gone, that's it, and you'll be kicking yourself in the ass. They always throw in some corny fucking shit on there, dude. Some fucking Blue Lives Matter shit.
Every fucking
not Blue Lives. All the
Monsters has fucking some gimmick. In the I have some so many cans shit. On one shelf. There's like fucking, I don't know how many fucking. Jesus Christ, there's gotta be like 30 different cans up there.
It's like fucking, I feel like it's like, you know, when fucking in WWE when they curse and it's like so forced and it's like they want it to come off like so like dirty and cool, but it's like so lame and they're like, you know, you're a bitch, and it's like, you said a fucking bad word, like, you know.
And then they cut it out of the promo package right for the pay per view.
Yeah, bitch, bitch.
You're up. Oh my god.
Yeah, they're like,
cut
shit.
It out. Dude.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You got PG that shit.
That's what it's like when on the back of the Monster cans when they say stuff like that.
So over dramatically fucking gimmicked.
You kick yourself in the ass.
For the mule kick, bro.
Fucking, our drinks are for people with testosterone.
They got fucking like dad jokes in that shit.
Yeah.
The mule? Huh. We kick him in the ass, huh?
The back of their cans low key degrade women every time.
Wait, what? What?
The back of their cans. The back of their cans low key degrade women.
Wait, where's the degrading women on the mule?
Oh, they all do that, dude. Look, what's it say here?
Degrading women for Christ's
sake? Spicy sweet ginger. What the fuck is that, dude? Spicy sweet ginger.
Who is that? Is it stripper?
Talking about ginger spice, dude. Who the fuck is spicy sweet ginger?
The Spice Girls, bro.
Oh, here you go. Yeah, fucking Monster Energy blend for a kick in the pants, sure to get you moving, morning or night.
Or night, huh? Morning or night.
So it's fucking saying, fucking drink that shit at night. It doesn't say you can go to sleep on it though. It says it'll get you moving. Oh, I think it's trying to, at night, dude, because it fucking wants you to fucking go out and get laid, dude.
It's a sex drink.
This drink is supposed to fucking help you get laid.
If you drink this drink, it increases your sex drive.
Why are we doing this full boogie advertisement for Monster Mule right now? But also Loki shitting on them at the same time.
So they're going to hear this shit.
I'm addicted to Monster Mule. I love Monster Mule. Their fucking shit tastes great. But the back of their fucking sayings, dude, corny, bro. Go hire the squash to write your fucking stupid shit, dude.
For Christ's sake, that'll be the next gimmick.
Come on, what a psychedelic mule, dude. A psychedelic fucking monster.
We need our own monster flavor fucking line,
yeah,
dude.
Dude.
The MBJ, dude.
What would it be? What would your flavor of monster be?
My flavor of monster, it would say fucking monster, and then underneath, it would be called the Gimmick King. My flavor would be Gimmick King. What would Gimmick King taste like?
Yes.
I would try to make Gimmick King soda. Gimmick King would taste like USA, but have that fucking monster fucking, you know, super carba fucking bubbly gimmick to it. Be like, replicate this fucking taste, dude. Are you owned by Pepsi as well? Can you fucking just take their fucking flavor? Can you just make this a USA knockoff? That would be the Gimmick King's monster
would
flavor.
Would you have a red, white, and blue flavor, like looking?
No, there would be a king on that shit.
Would be a king?
It would be a fucking black can with fucking gold and fucking crowns. That would be their fucking, their little side fucking decoration shit. The little monster logo would be a fucking gold one that was shiny. A shiny gold with fucking crowns for the Gimmick King. What would your flavor taste like?
I think I would do like a, trying to think of like what a good like a backwoods type of fucking flavor would be, dude. You know, like a psychedelic fucking woodland fucking flavor, like a pine whiskey ish Not really.
A whiskey-flavored Monster Energy to get you going.
I don't know what the fuck it would taste like, dude. I don't know, man. I really don't know what my shit would taste like.
You got to be ready to book it at all times.
I would try to taste like a campfire, you know?
I can't to recreate the taste.
How do you have a drink that tastes like a campfire?
I would say you got to recreate the taste of dry heaving on the top of that mountain, and maybe we can bottle some energy at the top of Mount Lafayette.
Mount Lafayette. Yeah, we'll fucking drink that shit.
As we open up like a Dew S.A.
We'll suckle. I've suckled on the rocks of mountain. Fucking Mount
You're going to see that shit. There's going to be a vlog. There will be a vlog. And we are on top of Mount Lafayette. If I find the right rock, hopefully I don't get COVID-19, but I will put my mouth on that shit, tongue and all, and suck and see what the fuck I can get out of that rock, if anything.
So, yeah. So, also, Sunday morning, when we wake up, we're going to try this place called Polly's Pancakes. And let me tell you, at my grandmother's funeral, there was a woman there that was balls deep, dude. And I have no idea who the fuck she was. And
what?
She had these crazy glasses like fucking John Lennon or some shit, you know?
Wait, did she have the same mask as you guys or something?
No, dude. I don't know who the fuck she was. Dude.
I feel like I know who she was. I mean, I don't know if she was, I don't know. I like, saw her. I feel
she had,
I know
like,
what you're
we called her Bonesy. She was like fucking mad skinny and shit. Like fucking Bonesy. We called her Bonesy. And like fucking, she had like, I don't know, she was just fucking balls deep, you know. And like, she wasn't my aunt. My aunt is tall, and she has glasses too. But this person had like round, like fucking, I don't know, she was whatever, dude. But she came to my house after the, for like food and
you
shit.
Don't even know her.
And she was like, she's back there, and she's like talking all this crazy shit. I don't know, she was just saying fucking crazy weird shit. And like, first of all, it was me and my cousin out there, like enjoying a nice meal by ourselves, talking about whatever. And she just sits down with like someone else in my family, my cousin, who's like known to be like a psycho, like a weirdo. Like we just don't, like no, everyone thinks she's like weird as fuck, you know. So they come out there, the two fucking balls deep fucking people in the fucking family. That one's not even in the family. Like I don't even know who she is. And they sit down and they start talking to us, and like she's just saying all this crazy shit. And I'm like, yeah, well, whatever. I'm going to New Hampshire. She tells me about this place, Polly Pancake House.
So she dropped the fucking
spot.
Like,
I'm like, all right, you know, cool. She's like, yeah, you should write it down. And I'm like, all right, yeah. And then she's like, no, no, like, do you have a phone or something?
Write it down right now.
And I'm like, yeah. She's like, yeah, you should write it down. And I'm like, all right, yeah, I will. She's like, what, you don't have, like, notes in there or anything? Like, write it down. And I was like, holy shit, like she really wants me to write this down, you know? And she was like, it's an incredible place. Like, you know, like you can go there and you can just pick out whatever mountain you want to hike, like right there. There's a map and everything. You just pick it out. And she's like, yeah, the pancakes are unreal, all that shit. So I was telling Brittany, and Brittany hates pancakes.
Yeah, I'm not the biggest pancake fan myself. You know, I like a chocolate.
She hates pancakes.
I'm okay with a chocolate chip pancake, but I'd rather anything else than pancakes. You know?
Really?
So, but this woman is saying,
she's balls deep.
Write it down. Write it down. This is the
write it down.
It's the most incredible pancakes ever. So like,
so
what?
I told fucking Brittany, and she was like, "Oh, do you have any idea what the syrup is gonna be like there?" I guess I'm like, it's not that close to Canada, you know. You really think it's that close to Canada that they're going to have maple syrup like fucking Canadians?
Wait, what? That's different?
I don't know. She says
they better have the racist syrup.
I'm sorry, Peek. She says they have crazy fucking maple syrup.
They better have racist syrup there. If they don't, I'm out. I'm just going to turn out and fucking walk out. I'm going to say,
I don't know. Maybe we won't go there. Maybe we will. But Polly's Pancake House in the morning sounds like an option for Sunday. And then I was thinking, you know, the tallest mountain in the White Mountains is called Mount Washington. Named after President George Washington. And it's something else, man. It's the tallest mountain in the entire Northeast.
Apparently, and, you can just drive
there's
up
a,
that
there, there's a road where you can drive up this shit. I'm going to Google this shit before I leave here. I want to YouTube the video of it and see what it's like. But I don't know, man. This road seems pretty crazy, bro.
I hope the fucking Civic does not fall off, bro.
I know. They say you fucking scale the side and you go straight up this mountain and it's like off the edge of the cliff of it, you know? And you know how I'm driving, you know what I'm saying?
What the fuck?
We'll be chilling there. We got to pick a nice mountain song to get up there with.
Oh my God, bro. I'm going to be fucking...
A fun fact about bluegrass music that I learned too that I thought was pretty cool is that like... The reason they call this shit bluegrass is because like, it was created by people that lived like in a mountainous region of the Appalachians. And when they looked out of their planes at the farmland and stuff, when they had their banjos and shit, and they were like ready to start making music, whatever, the grass looks blue when you're on the mountains. So you've never—I don't know if you've—you said you haven't been on the mountains in the East Coast, in you know, in New York, well, on the East Coast of America.
You're telling me I'm going to see some blue grass.
But when you're looking out into the valley, man, some of these mountains, they look blue, dude. It's, you know, it's grass. You know, it's like, it's not grass. It's like trees and shit. It's like the green. You think it would be green because it's like leaves and shit and trees, and you think it would be green, but it looks fucking blue.
This is a blue mountainous
hue. Because it reflects the oxygen or some shit, yeah?
Oh, oxygen reflection? Some balls deep shit?
Huh. Crazy shit.
Unreal. It's been one hell of an episode. I'm fucking... We, you know, this sounds like this adventure may take our lives, honestly. So we might, this might be the last one, dude. The last, the Squatch. And no, I'm playing. There's going to be more. There's going to be... Episode 14, when we tell our tale on this, there's going to be the vlog on the gimmicks. And just so you can check it all out, we got to do the follow at Man Bun Jesus on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at Man Bun Jesus 420 on TikTok. You can also go back on the Instagram, follow at the Groovy Grizzly, at Groovy Grizzly, at Fifth Dimension 420. You can go on YouTube, Man Bun Jesus. Oh, fucking, I'm fucking up today. I don't even know what my shit is. Man Bun Jesus TV. I am Johnny Radke TV, and you might be listening to this on the Radke Radio Productions YouTube channel or iTunes, holy shit, CastBox, or SoundCloud.com/TheSquatchAndTheBun. Unreal.
Unreal.
Absolutely unreal.
You can follow me at Psychedelic Sasquatch on Instagram. That's it. Bigfoot Benson on Twitter, but... I'm not really on there that much anymore.
You're not really on the Twitterverse too often?
With these people on Twitter, bro. I hate it. I hate Twitter. I hate these crybabies.
Oh, no. The
And I don't want to be any part of it, dude. I don't even like looking at it.
You don't want to fucking respond to them. You don't want to look in their direction. You don't even want to know that they exist. So you just don't even go on the app anymore.
Nope. Huh? I don't.
That's not a bad idea. You know, I hate Facebook. I'm thinking about getting rid of the book.
Barely look at that, too.
I don't know. I think maybe it's just I just got to start getting rid of people on there. You know what I mean? Every time I see something that pisses me off, you just got to go goodbye. You know what I mean? Maybe we just start kicking people to the curb like they do to you. Sometimes I post some shit people don't like, and they kick the bun to the curb. But other times, I don't like
that
shit.
What did he say? Flat earther? What? Anti-vaxxer?
Joe Biden is a pedophile?
Joe Biden?
You know?
I fucking hate these people, dude.
These people are the worst, dude. And with that being said,
what?
It is about that time. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, a little psychedelic WrestleMania 35 gimmick for you. With our many stories, with our adventure that is upon us, what a time it's going to be. I hope that we survive in the great name of the Kendo Stick Man, for Christ's sake. Ladies and gentlemen, remember that Man Bun Jesus loves you. Have a good day, a groovy night. Do the do, fill the fridge, and remember, every single day of your life, stay gold. And hopefully, we'll talk to you next time.